Hello, and welcome to Magzie's Fun Time. This is Magzie, and I did a test roll, and I am going to try to break this thing here. And it crashes, and there we go. We're perfectly good. So, I got everything back to the way it was, except for this side here, I believe, is one square shorter than it was before. And I need to put some dirt out here, but this will work now. I'm going to find some more stone. I did fall off the top of this, building this in the head, but luckily, I put all my stuff in here, except for that single stone. And we did get a sapling. But I used my last bone meal on the grass, and I got one of these avocado saplings too. So we'll see if that'll grow up. See what goes into it. If we have to, we'll go and plant it over here. So, and I got a couple extra saplings. No, I did get a couple extra saplings, but they were on me when I fell off. So, but I got these planted back the way we had them. And the rest of this in here as well. The rest of this, like this row here, and then this row here is probably going to be some of these crops that I got seeds from. I got artichoke, yellow seeds, chili peppers, and then regular wheat seed. So that's but today's episode, we are going to build a fence around this, and maybe we'll start on the platform. I don't want these episodes to get too long. So, we'll mine some stone out. I had 2 stacks of stone, but they fell off the leaves. And it was before I placed my bed, so I had to fall. It felt like before eternity. Until it actually placed me on the platform. Because apparently this platform isn't 20 blocks by 20 blocks. So. Yeah, it sucks. Or it might be, but it's not 20 blocks from 20 blocks from the center block. We're going to continue this as it is, and I will not update Horizons until either I find a glitch that requires it to be updated, or we do like a season 2. So, unless they force some kind of update. If they do update it again, I'll probably end up having to start a whole other world again, in which case we are going to do it the way I suggested, and we'll just start a new world in Horizons, and then I'll build the platform in the air as high as I possibly can. And then we'll start on the platform. Now we will be going to, we'll be going to the surface. And when that happens, I don't want to bring any blocks back with me that I can't get on this island. So, which basically means cobblestone. And of course, lava. Now, I can't get lava, so that means I can't bring lava back with me. But we can bring minerals and stuff. Get iron and stuff like that. Just no resource blocks like stones, and we get like seeds and stuff like that. But I'm not gonna allow. I'm not gonna allow any kind of That's the plan right now. We're gonna try to fish this pick out. And that should give us enough stone to make the walls. Everybody got their character up to max level. And then once you did that, there was PvP people who basically just did PvP stuff. For those of you who don't know, PvP is player versus player. Then there was PvE guys. All they did was max out their gear so they could run 5-mans and hang out with their friends. And then there was raiders. And raiders raided. So they got the max level gear they could rate it. And the PvE, each type of player had their own type of gear. So you would have, I need to do this off camera, so I'm going to go ahead and do it now. I want to make some charcoal. But we didn't have the furnace last time, but I went ahead and built it. But I didn't want to make the charcoal because I didn't do that last time. Anyway. So, as you were leveling, you joined a leveling game, which was PV. It was pro players that were PvE players, and all they like to do is just run dungeons. That's what they like to do. So you join one of them, and those people taught you how to run through dungeons, level, spec right, that kind of stuff. They taught you about rotation, just the basic tune stuff. Now I need to punch this one off every time it goes back. Anyway, so you joined a leveling guild to level you too. And those people ran dungeons with you. You had groups every week that ran dungeons, 5-man dungeons, and then everybody had their set roles. And you taught the tank to pull, how to pull, what groups to pull, when to pull, when not to pull, what to look for. And you also taught them, I think we're going to leave a gap here, because this is where we're going to come off right here. That kind of stuff. And basically, you taught them how to run dungeons right, and how to act when they're in a dungeon, all that kind of stuff. And what they basically did was it got them to, got them prepared for raiding guilds. Now your raiding guilds raided, and you didn't get into a raiding guild unless you had a certain item item level. Back then, it was gear score. Your gear score had to be a certain amount, and you had to actually have some experience raiding. So you had to do the you had to actually sit in Stormwind and do the pub raids and stuff like that before you could actually get into a nice guild. And yes, I see that. That we'll fix that. I think we'll leave a spot here too, because we can come up this way. And all the LCT people, I will come back and put stuff underneath here, so don't worry about that. It will be fixed. Anyway, so that's what we did. We had a guild. We started playing, and we started, and we got into the guild. They started teaching us some stuff about it, and I started paddling to help out with my professions. I need another tree before I can do that. I need some torches. I got 24. It's got 5 each, so I need at least 4 torches. And I don't want this to be left unlit. Let's go ahead and make them. Get a couple of double chests somewhere here with just full of cobblestone, so we don't have to worry about that. And then hopefully we can get I'm thinking of spawning in 3 quartz chests, so I can go ahead and make iron too, so we need the platform. Yeah, I need the iron for the name was Lux. Now I'm telling you his name because he was ally, now he's Horde, and his name is completely changed. So you won't be able to find him. If you do go on there, I was the first person ever to use the name Lilas. And it's spelled L-I-E-L-I-S, Lilas. And I was the first person to do that. Now there's like 300 people with Lilas used as the main name. Anyway, so. I can expand on you if I need to. So, I started the pally, and then before I could join the guild that he's in, this guy came up to me and was like, hey, I want to start this guild. I'll pay you 10 gold, and I want you to help me start the guild. And then once we get the guild started, you can quit. So I was like, sure, okay, I'll do that. So I get the rest of the signatures for the thing, and then I log out because I was working on my professions, and the only reason I started the tune was for the professions. A little bit more backstory. This is kind of a longer story than I thought it was going to be. But we used to play Dungeons & Dragons all the time. And the reason... And we need some more... Ooh, no. Ooh, don't do that. So... Anyway, there's a class in Dungeons & Dragons. The Dungeon Dragon story is a bit longer than what I'm wanting, and I'll tell that later or another time. But we played Dungeons and Dragons, and I hated being a pally. I hated it. I never liked the class. It's nothing against the class personally, just wasn't for me at all. And I used all of my stuff. I have some wood. If I do this, okay, I got two left over. Make sure I got enough. I got a pick. Oh, I'm such a dumb, very dumb person. Okay, anyway. So I logged back in. Because I never liked pallies, and I started the pally just so I could have the professionals, not to actually play the character. So I got to like level 15. 12 or 15 is what I got. I just left them solo to go on and make the characters. So I made it for them. The next time I logged back in, the dude had made me guild leader and then quit the guild. So I had like a free guild. And so we just ran with it. And we was the people. We did the research. We looked up all the classes. We started one of every class. We played it. We learned the rotations. We learned what to gear for, what stats to look for. Expansions come out, we found out what the best new specs was. We did all that kind of stuff, and then we talked to players. We joined, we invited all the new players we possibly could that we felt had the potential to be better players. And we trained them up. And I had a few connections on the server we were on, and with some rating deals. That I felt that was ready to move on to raiding, I would kind of, you know, I would whisper them in game, and I'd be like, okay, I got this guy here, and he's a good tank, or he's a good healer, and so if you try him out, see what, how he does, and then you can move on to y'all's guild. And that's what we was. Every once in a while, people would want to raid in our guild. We told everybody up front, we're not a raiding guild. We have no interest in raiding whatsoever. We're PvE people. We like running 5 men and hanging out with 2 guys and helping y'all out and just generally having a good time. Wow. And we don't want to go through the stress of jumping through hoops just so we can get one piece of gear that really has nothing to do with. Out of damage. very minute. Especially back then, when it was only like maybe 20 points more item level. And for anybody who plays WoW, 60% of your DPS in WoW is based on your player skill. Knowing your class, knowing your rotation, and all that stuff. Just 60% of your DPS is just your total skill. And how you run the class. It has nothing to do with the gear you have. So, worrying about gear when, like, my main by this time was a mage named Magzie. Just worrying about gear when I could do the same DPS that the Raiders, the Raider mages could do with just the PvE gear, to me, it wasn't worth it at all. And still to this day, I have no interest whatsoever in raiding. For me, I'll go every once in a while. It's not that I can't raid. I just don't like it. I mean, I go to help out friends in raids, and I'll plug in if, like, somebody, if, like, we're in a guild, and somebody didn't show up, and they needed another DPS, then I would go, okay, I'll plug in. But, other than that, I mean, I could. It's not the fact that I could. It's just, I didn't have fun doing it. I'm not the type of person that's going to figure out a strategy for a boss and then take 4 hours to kill the boss. Like for example, I helped the Gilbert now. I helped them do the Dragonfall bosses. And there's a boss in there where you basically have the melee team, and then you had the tank, and then you had the ranged team. And there was a healer on the melee team, and there was the ranged team. And you had the boss spit this little ball out. And you have to stand, spread it out, kind of, and try to get the ball bounced back and forth 5 times, and eventually back to the boss. So you bounce back and forth 5 times, and then hit the boss, and then do the maximum amount of damage. And Why? I can go run a dungeon, flat out DPS the boss and kill him, and then run another dungeon with my friends, a whole group of 5 people, and have a blast running through the dungeon and killing him, and chatting online or in vent. Why would I want to spend 4 hours in a dungeon to jump through hoops and tried to kill the boss within a certain amount of time, or have a whole 25-man, 40-man wipe because of a mechanic that we didn't get or we couldn't do. And maybe get gear. That didn't make no sense to me. It still doesn't. The only reason I played WoW was for hanging out. Hang out with my friends and socialize. That's it. And I'm not the only person. A lot of people play WoW just to do that. And since the most recent patches, Blizzard has gotten into the whole aspect of they want people to raid. Because that's content that they've made. Let me make some more platforms real quick. That's content that they made for people. I'm going to put 3 up here, just 6. And then we'll put. That concept. Blizzard got to the point to where it's our game. We made this. this stuff for y'all to play, and you're going to play it. And that's their mindset. That's their mindset now with the MOP expansion. We made the raid stuff, and we want you to play the raid stuff, so you're going to play the raid stuff. So they kind of like went out of their way when they made the expansion to make it more in tune with how you would actually play if you were actually raiding. So they put in more stuff where you were rep grinding. You had to rep grind to actually get the PvE gear. And basically what they did is they took out the PvE aspect of it. You were either leveling your tune to raid, or you were leveling your tune to PvP. And they didn't want anybody doing anything else but those two things. And then they added in the whole challenge mode thing to try to pacify the people that just PvE'd and liked doing challenging stuff without actually running raids and stuff. And they did a couple other things to try to pacify, but their main goal was to actually try to make it where you came in, played the game, and raided. And the PvE people that didn't like rep grinding to get gear, and they didn't like raiding, and they didn't like PvP, the only reason they wanted to be on there was to socialize and play with their friends and have fun. And those people, they're the ones that left. They're the ones that said, we don't like pandas, this is stupid to have this panda thing, because it was basically, they felt it was making fun of, or trying to cash in on the whole Kung Fu Panda movie. So, they, that's what they did. So, they left. And I think Blizzard's finally understanding, like, hey, you know, this was the problem, okay? When WoW did that, and the designers decided we want the raiding people to raid, then the raiders stayed because they liked that kind of stuff. And they did their usual stuff, they did the raiding stuff, and then they would quit, or some of them would quit once they got the maxed out tunes, and they wouldn't come back on until some new content came in. The PvE people that would train the new players left. And with no new players getting trained, that meant that all the new people and the younger people, because younger people came in, let's break this. All the younger people that came in and all the new players that came in, all the guilds that would have normally been PvE guilds that would have leveling guilds that would have trained people to actual level and how to run dungeons and stuff, did. And since those people left, there are only two kinds of people remained. The leveling guilds now are money guilds. They're not interested in training people how to level or how to run dungeons properly. The only thing they're interested in is making gold for their main character as a raider. And there's raiders. And raiders know how to use a class properly. So, say, like, I need some more fences. So the raid, for example, like a raider, a tank that would raid would start an alt to level, and it would be a tank, and he would get all the heirloom gear which is gear that levels with you, so you don't have to buy gear as you go, and it's like more powerful than the other gear you get, and it gives you bonus experience for leveling and that kind of stuff. Well, they would get that stuff, and then they would pool in dungeons and pool like half the dungeon they pool in one spot. And that's not what you want to do. You pool first group, you DPS them till you get your aggro up, and when they get about half health or lower, you move on to the next group. And as you move on, your DPS the rest of the group down. Your healer goes with you, because he's going to heal you and that group at the same time as he's moving forward. And he'll stop about halfway through, so you heal you and heal them, and then you pull the next group and start DPSing him. Your DPS clears that one and starts DPSing the group you have up and ready for them, and then when you get that group gets down far enough, you move on to the next group. And you do that in stages so that your cooldowns and all your moves come back up, so when you hit the next group, you got all your cooldowns back again. I'm going to make a pick in a second. We'll finish this ball. So. So when your cooldowns are down, and you can get aggro quicker on the groups, and you move faster, basically. And raiders don't. They'll pull this group, then this group, then this group, then this group. They'll grab aggro, move, grab aggro, move, grab aggro, move, grab aggro, move, until they get 5 or 6, 7 groups up in one big group. The only problem with that is that people that were not raiders can't keep up with that. People that just started out new can't heal that kind of attack for that much damage. They can't. They just can't do it. And that gets them frustrated. And that's all players know now. They've been one of the raiders that go and do that so long, but all the tanks do that. And it's basically ruins the PvE gameplay. To the point to where, I mean, all the people do that, it's crap. You can't get nothing done. You go to the dungeon, you get people pulling that kind of stuff, and all you ever do is keep dying over and over again until you find a queen. It's taking 5-6 hours to get through a dungeon. And I basically play now because my wife plays. I like to do stuff with her, so she plays and she gets on, and then I play and get on and do stuff with her, and then send her stuff. She's doing great stuff. But basically, I don't think WoW actually thought first about what they was actually getting rid of before then. I don't think they actually realized that the PvE people that they wanted to actually raid and the people that they actually lost because of that was the actual people that was training these other people. What we're going to do here is do this, and then we'll put a wind gate here. I'm at the point now in WoW to where I know every class. I know every class, what specs. And when the next expansion comes out, and then I just go and learn new specs. It takes me when I level my tune up, and then I'll look up the new specs, and then I'll just start doing it that way. And then I help my wife with her specs, and then by then we know all the new specs. And I'll help out, like, the guilds, our guilds, and help them out. This is pretty much safe. I think I want to put this one over here, because this one is not safe. So, that, this one is not black. Next tree that goes, I'll make sure to put them on the corners here. That one there, and that one there. Let's get some more food. I think this one is pumpkins. The rest of these are actual watermelons. And I think I might have to put dirt here. I'm not sure if that'll go in the way. We'll see. So, they basically they lost all the PvP people that was actually training players to be good players already. And now there's nobody training players as they level to be good players in dungeons. And running dungeons now is like pop. You're more likely to get struck by lightning than get the actual group of people that actually know what they're doing. So, I don't know. But, like, we've been through so much in WoW that, I mean, we don't have, we don't have the actual, stress levels to actually do the training of people. I mean, it sounds mean to say, but I mean, I don't know how else to say it. We had some personal problems in our life, and we got to the point to where so, I'm leaving that like it is, because that's fine, and I'll figure something out. The whole point of that, I'll tell you, is fix that later. So, here's what this happened. Here's what. Let's talk about for a while, because we're playing Minecraft. That's why I started playing Minecraft, because I like it. I mean, I can play by myself, I can go on server and play with other people, I know what I want, I can do anything I want in here, and it's not stressful for me, so it doesn't bother my crones or anything. And I can't go, like, maybe an hour and a half playing WoW anymore without stopping, because it's just too stressful for me now. I just can't with my crones the way my crones is. I just can't do it. But like on here, I can stress free for the most part. I can play 6-7 hours on this game without just minimal stomach cramps, and then I can tolerate all through those most of the time. Just every once in a while, I'll get a hard cramp. This is the way this works. Basically, you have to stand back a ways. We're going to put another layer on this eventually. But for now, we have to stay back a little way so that the creepers won't blow up when they come to the doorway. But all the other mobs, the spiders will actually come to you, so you can just back off. That's what the rails are for. So you can back off and hit them, and then they'll land in here most of the time. Sometimes they'll fall off the edge. And that's how that works. And the creepers, you'll be able to open this and just hit their feet. You can get rid of those. And this right here will keep them from blowing up here. It won't keep them blowing up on the sides here. Maybe we need to put like that. There we go. So that should be far enough away where they can't. Over there, they won't be able to blow up. And this will keep them from blowing up directly in front of you. And you can just open this and then swing the sword like that, and then kill stuff. The actual zombies and skeletons will burn up from the daylight. And that's the main goal for right now, is to actually just start getting drops. And we'll take this off and make it a wooden one too, eventually. Probably on the next episode. And add a second layer of walls around here. But that's the main goal. Start getting drops from mobs. I'd like to get a bow. And then we can actually turn that into the mob spawner later on. If you are playing along with me, Skyblock is on the Minecraft forums still. You just search for Skyblock, this is the upgraded original 1.0. There's a 2.0 that starts out with one platform and then has the second one off in the distance. It's not that one. This is the updated one from the original one that has the 12 wool in it, so you can make the bed. So, let y'all know that one. I know this is here, but I still squat. That's old habit. No! Oh well, I'll finish that later. So if you're playing along, this is your basic starting stages. This is because it's a frozen biome, still. And if we actually start doing the horizons the other way, we won't have to worry about doing this crap, which will be good. But the snow will destroy your crops, unless they fixed it. And I don't know if they fixed it, so I'm just keeping it this way just in case. But you want to make sure it's at least 3 high, unless you put it above these, which means it needs to be 4 high, because these grow up to 3. This is the sugar cane. And what you want to do with these is, eventually, you want these columns here to be on the sides here, and then connect it with a full platform on top. And then on the sides here, you want these two here to be dirt, and it'll be our infinite pool for those of you who have played Skyblock before, and two, it'll also serve as our sugarcane farm. And you won't need much sugarcane to start out with. All of our plants are fully grown, so we should be getting tons of these, so we shouldn't have to worry about food ever again. Another apple. The next episode, let's go ahead and get this tree back out of the way. What do y'all think we should do in the next episode? Give me some advice. I think a tree farm would be the most useful. We can start building the cool tools instead of using these crappy tools. So, in the comments, make sure you leave a comment. If you have played WoW, or you still do play WoW, let me know in the descriptions. If I think it's safe, I can put my character's name in and take a look at it. I'm not scared. I'm not a raider, so I don't need mech gear. And I mostly theory craft, so I don't usually keep the same type of stuff arm that I'm supposed to at all times. I usually run, try to run, it's gonna sound weird, but I run what stats I need for my spec, and I only look up when there's major changes that actually changes your rotation dramatically. Like, they changed everybody's mastery last time around, the last patch, the patch before last, and that changed completely how you play the classes. It changed it completely. So, just about everybody's mastery changed to something, whether it be good or bad. But, this is Magzie. And if you like this, make sure you like it. Subscribe for more videos. Let me know if in the descriptions, if you play WoW, go ahead and put your character's name or that. I don't know if you can place names. But just put your character's name down there and what server you're on, and I can look at it. That'd be cool. Other people can see that you play and what your character is. Unless you don't want that. You might just create any game, so beware of that. I'm going to put that down there if you want other people to know it too. Or you can email it to me. I have a Gmail account too, so I get the emails when y'all send me the comments. And I will see you on the next episode. And as we can see over there, you make it out 24 platforms here, because at 24 it starts spawning. It won't spawn before 24 blocks. So all them people out there will spawn, and then in the morning, 90% of them will burn up. So we'll go ahead and make us swords for that occasion. And I will go ahead and make craft load more stone and probably put a double chest here. And we'll just fill that up with cobblestone, and before each episode I'll just fill that whole thing up with cobblestone. Because we're going to need a crap load of it if we're going to go for the surface. If we're going to do the book thing, we're going to see how we come about on this kind of stuff here. You don't have to wait till morning. You can just wait till there's a whole crap load of people over there, and then sleep, and it'll be morning, and then they'll burn up. But you'll get more mobs over there if you wait till morning. And it's almost morning now. No, it just got dark. So anyway, this is Magzie, and I'll see you on the next episode.